estás, mi corazón. Ah, Feliciana. I hope you've made your special chicken and rice soup tonight. After a day like today, I could eat 100 bowls. Wait, why is it so quiet? Hey, it's okay. What's wrong, children? ¿Qué pasa? Something has gotten inside of here? A fox, perhaps? I'll see to it then. What the? Carlito? Carlito? Oh, poor Carlito. How could a fox do this? Santa Maria! What happened? My calves. My poor calves. What could have done this? Their chests. Their hearts. Come out. Come out, you devil.
Her voice. That is what I remember. Sometimes all that I remember. Low, sad, and beautiful. It is the voice I dream about at night. The voice that I cannot seem to escape from. Nor would I even try to. How do I capture that? How do I capture her voice and put it down here, into physical form? Maybe I should think of another memory. Maybe another time. No. No. It all keeps coming back to her voice. And the songs. This is so vexing! Just breathe. You can do this. Just breathe. That is what the doctor would tell you. Now, this is better. Yes, much better. Form and structure. That is what you need to keep remembering. Form and structure. And your voice.
Christine?
Doctor, you startled me.
I'm sorry, my dear girl. I was just walking by when I heard you talking to yourself. Now, talking to oneself is commonly considered the first sign of insanity. Or are you still suffering the effects of Supremo's manipulative mental manacles?
No. No. I'm quite recovered from that, thank you. That was a rather strange adventure, was it not? And what did he try to trap you in? His watery wombs of woeful whales?
Indeed. But really, Chris, you must take me for some naive schoolboy.
Sorry?
Trying to change subject on me? I can tell when secrets are being kept. Tell me, what are you doing? What are you trying to hide?
Nothing, Doctor.
Don't lie to me. I know when you're trying to be deceptive, and quite frankly, Christine, you're no good at it.
Is that so?
Yes. Come on, don't keep me in suspense. What are you working on?
Doctor, I would rather not talk about it.
Well, suit yourself then. I'll have you know that my opinion is worth great currency in at least 5 galaxies. Maybe 6 if I could ever get that misunderstanding over my license resolved. It's really your loss.
Doctor...
Did you feel that?
Feel what?
We've landed already.
Hey, wait for me!
Now that's interesting. Well?
What?
Aren't you going to ask me, what is it, Doctor?
I assumed that you would just tell me what you have found so interesting.
You really are becoming a feisty young lady, aren't you?
Feisty?
Don't you try to play little medieval innocent with me. I'm wise to your ways now. Some of the sensors are offline. I'm not getting a completely accurate sensor sweep of the area. I really should get the TARDIS back up to snuff. I've been letting it slide too much lately. The ship's not getting any younger. And neither am I.
Can we go outside and look?
Oh, yes, definitely. It's perfectly safe. In fact, we've landed back on Earth.
Now, there is a surprise.
What does that mean?
Nothing, Doctor.
You're indeed becoming feisty. Let's go have a look, then.
It's getting dark. It must be night soon.
Or almost morning. The glass isn't always half empty, Chris. Still, we'd best move along. Rather rural area, I must say.
Why say you such?
observe your surroundings. There are no lampposts of any kind. The roads look nothing more than trodden ground. If I didn't know any better, I dare say this looks quite like your time.
Surely we are not back in Drachmore.
Oh, no. I'm sure we're nowhere near the 13th century.
Thank God.
Such bitterness, Christine. It doesn't suit your countenance.
Thank you, Doctor. I think...
Well, actually, never mind. Come on now, let's not totter.
Doctor, you have getting mud all over your shoes.
Yes, I know. I'm glad to see that you find a great deal of humor in this. Time travel is not without its risks. It's certainly not for the faint-hearted.
Or for people with nice shoes.
These were my favorite pair, too.
Oh, Doctor. It is so hot and humid here. You certainly picked a fine spot for a walkabout. Just where are we exactly?
I didn't pick it, Christine. The TARDIS simply landed here randomly. We must be in some tropical part of the world. Not Spain. I wonder where... Ah, a store! Look there, up ahead, with a gas light out front. Maybe I'll be able to wipe the mud off my shoes.
Not again? Doctor, wait for me!
Good evening. Or is it morning?
Hola, señor. Señorita. Buenos noches.
Ah, evening. See, Chris, I was right. My good fellow, pardon the intrusion so late in the evening. I'm the doctor, and this is my friend Christine.
Hello, sir.
What can I do for you?
What do you recommend in the way of local brews?
We have a fine selection. Some Bacardi, perhaps.
Excellent. Christine?
I will have that, too.
No, you won't. She'll have juice.
Apple, guava, pineapple, coconut.
Apple juice, please.
Coming right up.
Of course, I knew it. I told you, Christine. I have an unerring sense of direction.
Is that so?
I'm
over here, Doctor.
Oh, yes, I see. Well, you wondered where we landed, and here it is, staring us in the face. According to this wall calendar here, we've landed in Puerto Rico, 1901, to be exact.
I've never heard of Puerto Rico.
Well, it's a small island in the Caribbean, which is across the ocean from where you once called home. It wasn't discovered by Europe until a couple of hundred years after your time. In fact, we've come at a rather interesting period in its history. Yes, indeed. No wonder the store owner looked at me rather strangely.
I do not think I follow you, Doctor.
We've arrived a couple of years after a brief conflict called the Spanish-American War. The United States, that is one of the major world powers at this point in history, fought a war against Spain and won. In doing so, they gained several land possessions, and Puerto Rico was one of them. I imagine that the locals are still finding it a bit difficult to adjust to life under a whole different nation and culture.
Is it really so horrible? These people do not seem to be in servitude to any masters.
Well, Christine, imagine if the French had conquered England.
Bite your tongue, Doctor!
Ah, see, my dear? Anyway, it was mostly politics that moved these people under the possession of the United States.
Nonetheless, I can understand their feelings. It does not take away from the land, though. It is so beautiful, so full of life. Perhaps too full of life. I do not like these bugs. Will we be staying?
Here you go.
At least for the drinks we are. Ah, thank you very much. How much do I owe you?
You are not from around here, are you?
We tend to travel around a lot. Broadens the mind. Don't get around much yourself, do you?
No, senor. I don't.
Well, here you go. This should cover the drinks and a little extra for the service.
Thank you again.
Was it too little?
Orlando, what's wrong with you?
A drink, Anacencio. Please, a drink.
You seem as though the devil were chasing you.
I think I would have preferred the devil.
What are you talking about, Orlando?
Doctor.
I'm sorry, Anacencio. I didn't mean to barge in like this with customers in your store.
Us? Oh, don't mind us. Please, carry on. What about this devil?
Perhaps you would like to speak to me privately.
No, it's okay. I had gone up to my farm to check on the cattle and to get things in order for the night. But when I got there, the cattle seemed disturbed. Something seemed to have startled them. At first, I thought that perhaps a fox had gotten in there. I'm sorry.
Don't worry about it. Your hands are shaking horribly. I've never seen you this scared before.
I heard something. Maybe it was the wind. Maybe I'm just crazy. I took out my machete and crept around the side of the feeding area. I found several of the calves. Dead.
Dead? How?
Slaughtered. They were slaughtered, Sensio. It was horrible. The hearts. It was their hearts.
Their hearts?
Their hearts had been cut out.
Really?
You think me a liar? The holes, their flesh, it was mutilated. And there seemed to be strange symbols carved into their flesh.
Symbols? Now that is interesting.
That is horrible!
Indeed. Orlando, that's your name, right?
Yes, sir.
Is your farm nearby?
Not far. A little up that steep hill over there, and on the other side.
I'd like to take a look at your calves, if you don't mind. Perhaps there's something I can do to help.
Are you some sort of law officer?
No, I'm more of a doctor.
Doctor?
Well, the doctor, actually. The genuine article and all that.
It's getting late. It'll be dark before long.
All the more reason to hurry up and take a look. Christine, why don't you take a trip back to the TARDIS?
What? I should not tarry behind!
This is not a place for young ladies to go. I would not take my own daughter to such a sight.
I think not! I want to go with you, Doctor! I'm not a little girl, you know!
A fact I keep finding myself reminded of. Quite a lot lately. Very well, you can come.
Are you certain that you want to go there now?
Yes, please. No time like the present, so I've said.
Orlando, I don't know if that's such a good idea.
It's okay, Sensio. The doctor seems trustworthy.
Some say it's my smile.
I'm sure. Let's go then.
I'm ready to do this, Raphael.
Not again, Rosa. We've been through this already. How many times are you going to keep bringing it up?
Why are you so adamant to wait?
Why are you in such a hurry?
We have been working so long for this moment, Raphael. We are too close to delay now. I am ready to perform the rituals.
No, it's too soon.
Why? Because he said so.
The hermit has been guiding us this whole time, Rosa. He hasn't given us a reason to distrust him.
If you want my opinion...
No, actually, I...
He's been taking too long. We could have been finished long ago.
Is that so? Do you think that we would have been any more successful without the hermit's help? Or that we would even be able to successfully contain the awesome power that he presents to us?
You idolize him too much.
No, Rosa, you're wrong. I idolize my country, our people, our culture. I want to preserve it, to keep it intact from the coming storm of the gringos.
We don't need the hermit to stop the storm, Raphael. We have the rituals in place. We have the scrolls. We have each other.
Rosa, stop that. Stop using us in this way.
Why do you rebuke me? Because you fear him? You fear that he would not approve of your being involved with such a foolish woman like me?
You are foolish, Rosa. You are impatient, headstrong, and untrusting. The hermit will guide our people to independence. He will give us the strength we need. He has already taken us most of the way. We just need faith and patience, and he will help us complete our journey.
I have faith in what we can accomplish. I do not have faith in him, however. Something is wrong. There's a reason why it's taking longer than it should, and I know the hermit is holding back from us. That's why I need to perform the ritual tonight.
No, Rosa, or God help me, I will...
Oh, you what? What will you do?
Don't you dare question me again, nor question the hermit's judgment. You will wait, and that's it.
Is that so?
This is your final warning, Rosa. Remember what I have said. I will contact you later.
We shall see, Raphael, my dear. We shall see.
Well, that wasn't too bad a trip.
Speak for yourself. I am fairly spent.
Remember, you insisted on coming.
Over there, past the fence and around the shed. That's where I found... where I found the bodies. Right around here. Are you sure that you want the señorita to see this?
No, but it appears that she has already made that decision for us.
Very well. I couldn't imagine showing my daughter Raquel anything like this.
You do not know the things I have seen.
No, I suppose not. There. There they are.
Horrible!
Yes. Most fascinating.
Fascinating?
Oh, Orlando, I'm deeply sorry about your calves. Nothing, not even animals, deserve such a treatment. As something of a scientist myself, however, these are of some interest. Look here. These markings on the flesh are not random slashes. These are definitely symbols, as you have suggested. They are strange, even alien-looking.
Doctor, have you seen them before?
I don't recall. However, my memories have been known to be flaky over the past couple of years.
That is comforting. And yet, somehow not surprising.
You are familiar with these things, senor?
I am familiar with a great deal of things, my good man. See here. See how the hearts were removed? The finesse of these cuts. Simply fascinating with such exquisite precision. And also very disconcerting.
So you have seen this before?
Not exactly the same, but close enough.
Memory failing you again, Doctor?
Cute. Very cute, my dear. No, I would say that whomever did this knew exactly what they were doing. It wouldn't be so troubling if it didn't appear a bit anachronistic.
Okay.
Oh, it's just that I...
What is that?
Something. Something's over there.
Ah!
It's just a fox. It must have sensed the dead calves. It's okay, Christine. There's nothing to be frightened of.
Me frightened? What about you?
Me? Nonsense.
Wait, did you hear that?
Nonsense? He does swag! Hercules himself could not grip my hand with such force as you did.
Your scream just startled me, that's all.
Did you hear that?
Admit it! You were frightened too away!
I think there is someone else here.
I was only concerned about you. Is that so wrong?
I think it's coming from...
Wait, Orlando, did you just say that... Orlando, watch out!
Doctor! The lantern! I cannot see!
Doctor, help! He has a knife!
Hold on!
Doctor, no! Doctor!
They both fell down the hill.
Where? Where is he? I cannot see him!
Señorita! Help me find the lantern. We'll need it if we're going to help the doctor.
Hurry! I found it!
The doctor.
We have to find him! Please!
Christine, don't run too far ahead. It's too dark.
Over here! Hurry! Doctor!
Oh, Christine. Ah, there you are. I was worried about you.
About me? Are you all right?
I just had the wind knocked out of me. Did you get a good look at the attacker?
No! Did you, sir?
I'm afraid not.
Oh, the moment he saw you two coming, he turned and ran. A coward. Still, I couldn't get a good look at his face.
Why would anyone try to kill me? Try to do this to my cattle?
You don't have any enemies, anyone who would hold a grudge against you.
Doctor, I am a simple man. I work my farm, I raise my family, and I believe in God. I don't try to bother anyone. I'm not aware of anyone who would want to do this to me.
Well, nevertheless, it would be wise to keep our wits about us until we find out who did this.
Doctor, I am grateful for your help and for saving my life. Please, come to my home for dinner. It is the least that I could do to repay you.
Well, that is very kind of you, Orlando. What do you think, Christine?
Twas be an honor, sir.
Bueno. And I think that my daughter Raquel would very much love to meet you, Christine.
It would be nice to meet someone my age for a change.
Yes, I think the two of you will get along very well. Well, let's hurry before our attacker decides to return.
And before dinner gets cold.
Indeed. Lead on, my friend.
A pleasure to meet you, Senator Dawson. And you as well, Mrs. Dawson.
A pleasure.
Likewise, Governor Allen.
I trust that your trip to Puerto Rico went well.
Yes, it was very pleasant. I must admit I was anxious to arrive. I've heard so much about the island.
Puerto Rico is certainly one of the brightest gems we acquired after our war with Spain.
Was it really a war, after all?
Here's our cab. Shall we continue on to the hotel?
Certainly.
Allow me to assist you, Mrs. Dawson.
Why, thank you.
So tell me, Mr. Allen,
Please, call me Charles.
Charles. So how has it been here over the past year? How have the natives, shall we say, been adjusting to our presence?
Well, to be honest, it has not been without its challenges. These people have a rather independent spirit, though many are quite hospitable. It's an interesting combination.
Indeed. Do you think they'll accept U.S. control in the long term?
Do they really have a choice?
No, I suppose not. Some people back home have brought up various options. Statehood, allowing them independence, or keeping them peripherally attached. Some don't want to be bothered at all, it seems.
Why is that?
I suppose it's just that they're a different culture. Maybe a little too different?
Curious. The Union was made up of various cultures once.
Right. I don't think it will be an issue. The sugarcane alone that Puerto Rico produces will certainly be valuable to us. That will have some back home thinking twice about allowing Puerto Rico its independence.
Always about money, is it, sir?
Not always. But it helps.
The local people, they're concerned as well. They don't want to lose their cultural identity. Some are still upset about us forcing them to use American currency.
Oh, they should be happy to use our currency. The peso isn't worth the paper it's printed on anyway.
Imagine if the US went back to using British pounds.
The sentiment isn't lost on me, Charles. I understand that this change is difficult for the people here, but what we offer is much more than what Spain would do for them. We're planning on a university, getting roads paved, and even looking into suffrage. All of this and more.
You'll get no arguments from me, but still, change is difficult.
Only for those who are afraid of it. I hope my visit here will allay some of those fears. We can make this transition work painlessly.
I hope so, sir. We've arrived. I hope that you both sleep well tonight. I'll see you in the morning.
Good night.
Buenas noches.
That was an absolutely wonderful meal.
Why, thank you very much. Somebody had to feed Orlando, and I found myself doing it out of pity. Somehow, I never brought myself to quit this job.
Feliciana is the best cook in this corner of the island. That's why I had to marry her. I wanted her cooking all to myself.
Very funny. Raquel, could you please help me put these dishes away?
Yes, Mama.
Allow me to help as well.
Look at them, Doctor.
Hmm?
They live such simple lives. They are poor, yet so happy with each other. Because they are a family.
Yes, family. A truly wonderful thing.
Doctor, I do not think you have ever told me. Do you have a family?
Family. I've met many people across my lifetime, Christine. People like you, whom I consider my family. When you're like me and you live such a long time, it can be difficult sometimes to keep people close to you. You see them wither with age and die, but you live on. It's almost a cheat to go back in time and see them alive again. It hurts because you know the fate that awaits them.
Do you know what awaits me then?
No one's fate is set in stone, Christine. No one's.
But you just said... Oh, never mind. But you were saying about your family. You have never had one of your own.
I have my granddaughter, Susan. She's the only real family I have left. The others, well, that's not important now.
Christine, I've finished helping my mother. Would you like to talk some more?
I would love to. Is that all right, Doctor?
Of course, my dear, of course. Feliciana, would you like some help with those dishes?
I'm fine, gracias.
It's wonderful to see Raquel and Christine getting along.
Yes, I agree. It is unfortunate that Christine doesn't have her parents. Children need stability in their lives.
Oh, that's a shame about her parents. What happened to them?
She doesn't talk about them very much. All I know is that they died when she was younger.
So you've been taking care of her?
Yes, we travel around together quite a bit.
So really, you're her only family. You're almost like her adopted father.
You know, I never thought of it like that.
You must know what a responsibility it is. I thank God every day that I have Feliciana in my life. Girls, sometimes they need a woman's touch to teach them things us men cannot.
I never thought about that either.
But you've obviously done a great job with her. Christina's a wonderful young lady. Very bright and very respectful.
Still, she may benefit from a motherly figure, and more children her age. I never considered how selfish I've been.
Children are truly a blessing. I don't know what I'd do without Raquel. Why don't you come with me to get some fresh air, amigo? Sometimes I like to take a walk after dinner. It helps keep me young.
That sounds exactly like what the doctor ordered.
Raphael, you are a fool. The hermit does not know as much as he thinks he does. It is time, whether you want to believe it or not. Yes, now is the time. Commonstre rise secur viamento. Rena obscuridad de sangre turbidomen. It's working. It's working. Sipato sayuna obscuridad se sangre turbidomen. Teresada tun ras dulcomento. Un commenstri rasgai viamento. Rena obscuridad de sangre torvidamento. Sabata sayami obscuridad se sangre torvidamento. Teresada tun ras dulcomento. Wait, what's wrong? No, wait. It can't be. No.
So, Doctor, do you have any further thoughts on the mutilations?
Well, I...
What was that?
This way, come on!
Ay, Dios mío! The house! The house has been destroyed! What could have done this?
Orlando, quick, help me!
Doctor, over here! I found someone!
Careful! Let's turn her over.
Rosa.
You know her?
I have nothing to do with her kind. She practices Santeria.
The occult?
Yes.
Nevertheless, we need to help her.
Don't misunderstand me, Doctor. I will help her because of my belief in God. But I do not agree with her way of life.
Well, she's alive, but in need of medical attention. Where's the nearest hospital?
There's one in town, not far from here.
Good. Good. We'll take her there, then. Is there anyone else here? Does anyone else need help?
Rosa lived alone. She was a rather reclusive woman. I don't think anyone else would be here. Besides, do you really think anyone could still be alive after what happened to this place?
Oh my.
What is it?
There's a man in here. Dead, too. Wait a minute. That's impossible. He's completely unharmed. Not a scratch or a bruise from the falling debris.
That's impossible.
But the proof is here before us.
But how could that be?
Quite an extraordinary house, I'd say. Or an extraordinary murderer.
He looks like a foreigner. Perhaps from the United States.
Yes, he does have that look about him. Well, let's see. Here we go. Some ID. Dawson. William H. Dawson, a United States senator.
But what is he doing out here, in this part of the island? There are no major ports around here.
I don't know. Orlando, please, go get help.
Yes, yes, of course.
Doctor! I heard screaming! What is happening?
Some sort of catastrophe, it would seem.
That man... is he?
Yes, he is, Christine. The woman is still alive, though. But this doesn't make any sense.
Ah! Doctor! What does that mean?
Christine! Get behind me, now!
There's some shadow people! Ah! Doctor!
Christine, run! Get out of here!
Keep away from me, shadow beast! Keep away from me! Ah! Doctor, help me!
Let her go! Stop it! You're killing her! Christine! Ah!